Hello everyone, welcome back to Coding with T. Today we are going to start a new course of Riverpod state management. And in this course, we are going to definitely cover each and every concept of Riverpod right from the beginning till we are going to create a complete CRUD in which you will be able to later on create your complete applications. So this course is going to be very informative. Make sure to hit the like and subscribe button and turn on the bell notification so you get notified for each new update. First of all, let's see the problem without going into details of what is Riverpod and how we're going to use it and what is about this playlist. The problem is that you might have spent hours in debugging your code and your UI is not updating, but you want to update it. But in other case, you might do not want to update the UI, but UI is again going to be updated repeatedly. Maybe you have used SetStateProvider or GetX and wondered why does the widget rebuild when I don't want it. Maybe you never try to write the test case because you think that it's going to be very complex. And you do not ever write unit test or another test cases for your application. Or maybe you are thinking that how do I'm going to clean up my widgets or the resources whenever the widget is not mounted or when the widget is removed from the screen. You want to clean up your resources, but you are worried about manual handling of each and every case, like removing the text editing controllers from the memory if you have the streams going on. And if you're going to remove the streams, then you again have to start a new stream when the screen again appears on which your stream is being displayed. So you are not alone in this whole world, because these are the type of errors that most of the Flutter community is facing. So without going into details of how we're going to solve it, first of all, let's see what is Riverpod, a brief history of the Riverpod, and what are the benefits of using Riverpod. So in 2017, first of all, set state and inherited widget was introduced, which are the built-in feature of the Flutter. And we have to use these two things to update our user interface. We slowly start realizing by the Flutter team and by the people who are using Flutter that for the large apps or for the large widgets, it is not a feasible thing to redraw the whole widget just by calling the set state. So this is not a recommended way. Then later on, people start introducing different type of state managements. And this is the reason why it is being called state management, because we have to manage the state. We do not want to update the whole state, the whole user interface. Rather, we only want to update the specific thing. So this is again a positive thing of Riverpod. Then later on in 2018 and 2019, in the mid of that, Provider was being launched by the author named Remy Rosseld, if I'm going to pronounce it rightly. So he introduced the provider package, and that provider package was again aiming to simplify the inherited widget logic, but still it is going to rely on the widget's context. And if you are coming from the provider background, you know that we have to call provider.ofContext. So context is there. So this means again we had some limitations, testing complexity, and a lot of other things that we are not going to dig into the provider, but definitely later on the same author, he realized that okay, now we have a lot of issues that start rising in the provider package. So instead of at that time, when he realized after a year or so in 2020, at that time, there are a lot of users of provider and he was not in position to completely redraw or update the provider package. So he decided to create a new package, which is called the Riverpod. So again, in the provider, you see we have providers. So in the Riverpod by name, you can see it is a river of providers. So we'll dig into what is provider later on. So he overcome all the issues. There was no context involved in the Riverpod. It is a pure Dart code and strong compile time guarantees. So first of all, he launches the V1 in 2021 and introduced different type of providers. Again, we will dig into the providers as we proceed. So first of all, we have provider, state provider, future provider, stream provider, and definitely to update the user interface is introduced consumer widget and widget reference. So all these things will be covered. But later on in the V2, again, he improved a lot of things. He removed a lot of boilerplate and he introduced another thing or another first class annotation approach using Riverpod generator package. Again, we will cover each and every concept and introduce notifiers and async notifiers that are going to efficiently handle all the API calls. And he introduced again a built-in support for dot select to specifically update only one single text widget, and he introduced the family package and autoDispose. So these are a lot of things that have been introduced in 2023, where the version 2 is the biggest update we had ever after the launch of the Riverpod. Okay, now what is Riverpod? A Riverpod is a state management, a Dart native state management, because it is written only specifically into the Dart language. So that's why I'm calling it a Dart state management or Dart native state management, and a dependency injection library for Flutter. So you see, I focused on the dependency injection. If you're coming from the getex approach or from the provider, you know that we have to integrate or handle dependencies individually. Let's say we have a controller called auth controller, and you forget to call get.put auth controller at the first time when the application hits the auth controller, and you are calling later on, you're calling get.find, but there is no get.put, right? We will directly get the exception in the code. So this exception is the dependency injection problem that we have to manually handle inside getex. But in the Riverpod, we do not have to worry about for the any kind of dependency injection in the Riverpod, because it is going to efficiently handle by itself. We just have to call whatever we want, and dependency injection is no longer even discussable problem in the Riverpod. Next, it is going to provide a compile time safety. So what is compile time versus runtime? If you run the application and application is running actually, and at that time we face any exception, because in the getex we face a lot of exceptions when the application runs. So that is called the runtime. And when it comes to the compile time, it means that when we are writing our code, at that time we see a red line in the code that you have to write getex controller, you have to override this, you cannot run your application until your compile time errors are gone. So that is another very beautiful thing for the developer community, because we do not have to wait for the application to run and then we will get a new error and then we again have to stop it and, you know, we have to do all the fixations. But in the Riverpod, we just have to fix all the compile time errors and that's it. You're done with the compile time safety. Then there is no hidden context, means you do not have to worry about the context. Rather, you just have to use the ref object. We will cover it later on, and you just have to call it and you will be able to access each and every provider you want. Then another thing is test first, means Riverpod is a test first approach. It is going to wrap all the providers inside a provider container so that we can easily test them later on, and specifically used as isolated unit testing. In getex and in provider, you are not able to test because we have a lot of things interrelated with each other and we are not able to write test cases easily. But with time, you will be able to see that how easy it is to write test cases in Riverpod. And then, so another point is scoping and disposal, which means that you will have a fine grain control over the lifecycle of providers. You can also call the autoDispose to free resources when no longer needed. So this is again another benefit. And it has the efficiency of automatic cleaning up all the resources if they are no longer needed. So you do not have to again manually call autoDispose, but you can definitely do so. Okay, first of all, as you are not aware with the Riverpod, I just want to share you an example. Do not go into the details of what is provider scope, but first let's see. We have our Flutter application. Void main is the first function that is going to be started. Then in the run app, we have the provider scope before we are going to run actual application, or the actual widget tree is going to be built. Above all the Flutter widget tree, we have the provider scope on top of it, because in the run app, first of all, we are going to wrap everything with the provider scope. So this is specific to Riverpod. And now if you see how Flutter tree is going to be created, we have the material app, and in the material app we have different type of widgets, as you can see under the hood, and each widget will have its own scaffold and columns, rows, text, and so on and so forth. So this is a type of tree that start creating in the Flutter. And let's say the last node is going to require something which is right on top of it, so you just have to call his parents to get a controller, maybe whatever you want to call a type of variable which is global and he want to use it, he have to call his parent, and definitely because it is a child, he can inherit that specific variable class or whatever we want to use down below in the widget tree. But on the left side, if you see, if that specific variable controller, let's say you call the get.put and it is not in the tree, and you again have to call get.put, you again have to add that controller in the memory. So it was there on the left side of the widget tree, or maybe in another cycle it was there in the widget tree but you was not able to find that, we again have to call get.put. Or if it was somehow removed, you are not even aware of that, okay, that controller is removed from the memory or the resources are empty, now I have to call get dot put instead of get.find. So these are the problems that start arising when we are only dealing with the widget tree inside Flutter. So most of the state managements work over here. But now if we wrap our code right after run app, we have provider scope and then we have the whole widget tree. So let's treat the provider scope as a separate thing. And then, or at the top, you can place the provider scope and then down below you have your widget tree. So let's treat them side by side. So on the left side, you can see we have the provider scope. And on the right, we have our material app and the complete widget tree. So now what Riverpod is going to do, let's say you want to need a provider, because whatever provider we are going to create, every provider will go inside the provider scope. So no matter what type of provider it is, it's a future provider, a stream provider, a state provider, async notifier provider, whatever type of provider that we're going to learn will all go inside the provider scope. So they are not part of the widget tree actually. So they are on the top of it or on the left side. They are not part of it. So any widget at any screen, you just have to call widget ref, which is again a part of provider scope and allowing you to call any provider. You just have to name the provider. Let's say provider name is XYZ. So you need XYZ provider and it is right there in front of you. You do not have to call get.put, get.find. You do not have to be worried about each and everything. Okay, now let's jump back toward our playlist. So we're going to divide our playlist into two phases. The phase one is going to learn how to create manual providers and consumers. This is going to be very powerful and very important section. So it will have three sections, and the section two or the phase two will be code generation with Riverpod. With @Riverpod means Riverpod generator we are going to use to generate our code. So it will again have three sections. So the section one will be code providers, in which we're going to cover, definitely this is the first video of the roadmap and introduction. The second video is going to be provider itself, the read-only provider, then state provider, which is going to be mutable state. We can change the state. Then we will learn how to use stateful consumer widget, deep dive. Everything will be covered again. So section two will cover asynchronous programming and modifiers. So we will have the future provider, stream provider, and the features we have dot family and auto dispose that we are going to use with any provider. Then we have the section three. We will see how computed and derived states are going to work, performance with the select approach, which is again a new feature of Riverpod. And we will do some overrides and testing inside our application. Then in the phase two, we have the section four, where we're going to generate the basics. We will learn how to set up the Riverpod generator package and how to even generate simple providers that we created above using Riverpod generator. Then we again use the same package to see the notifier and async notifier using code generation. We will again see the family and auto dispose with the code generation. Then we're going to create the real example of full to-do app, testing and debugging of generated providers, and definitely the next step and the ecosystem that we're going to discuss, that how we can use other things along with the Riverpod. So this will be our playlist. And if you have any question about the Riverpod, you can ask me down below in the comments. And if you want to modify or if you want to add any tutorial inside this playlist, I am free to add them. Definitely they will not be part of this specific tutorial, but you can get them and I'll drop the link down below in the description of this playlist. Once again, thank you for watching, and if you're new, make sure to like and subscribe, and to follow the complete course, make sure to hit the bell icon so that you can get notified about all the new upcoming videos. Thank you for watching and take care.